Crown Prince Mary, Executive Director of UN Women, Ms. Phumzile Mlambo-Ngcuka, Excellencies, distinguished delegates, colleagues, and friends. I am indeed very happy to welcome you all to the UNECE preparatory meeting for the 20-year review of the Beijing Declaration and Platform for Action. I would like to welcome our guest of honor, Her Royal Highness Crown Princess Mary of Denmark, and the distinguished co-host of our meeting, the Executive Director of UN Women, Ms. Phumzile Mlambo-Ngcuka. Let me also start by thanking our co-host, UN Women, and their regional office, as well as the regional offices of UNDP, UNICEF, UNFPA, ILO, and FAO for their substantive support to this meeting. And thank Denmark and the Netherlands for their generous contributions, which have made possible to have strong participation from all over our region. It is very encouraging that we today have 500 or more even representatives of governments, civil societies, companies, academia, have come here to discuss our region's achievements and challenges in the area of gender equality. It is encouraging that almost all UNECE member states have sent us their national reports, and it is encouraging that 700 representatives from 350 women's groups and civil society organizations have met in this room during the past 3 days to discuss gender equality. The strong engagement shows that gender equality is a top priority for the ECE region. It was in 1995 that the countries of the world came together at the Fourth World Conference on Women and agreed on the Beijing Declaration and Platform for Action. This framework was a game changer. It showed the path to a world where equal rights and opportunities for women and men, for girls and boys, would prevail. It helped, and it has helped, to improve the lives of millions of women and girls around in the world. And now next year, the United Nations Commission on the Status of Women will commemorate the 20 years anniversary of the Beijing Platform of Action. And next year, we must agree on an ambitious set of sustainable development goals towards 2030, hopefully with a strong goal on gender equality and strong gender targets within all goals. And this is why it's so important that we today and tomorrow provide a strong voice from our region into the global dialogue on gender equality. At this meeting, we'll take stock of what we have accomplished over the past 2 decades. And I hope and I trust that we will hear encouraging and inspiring stories and statistics. But we will also hear that much remains to be done to achieve gender equality. Our goal is to identify the obstacles that hinder full empowerment of women and find the policies, measures, and actions that can remove them. Let us use this meeting as an opportunity to fulfill and reaffirm, and hopefully soon fulfill, our commitment to the Beijing framework, to gender equality, and to women's empowerment. The interactive panels will focus on 5 issues: progress and setbacks, economic and social policies, women's representation in decision-making, violence against women, gender justice, and finally, how do we move ahead? The regional synthesis report, which I really encourage you to read, shows strong political progress, lots of inspiring best practices, many institutional improvements that promote gender equality throughout our region on all issues. However, it is also shown that too often implementation lags behind. Women's economic opportunities has indeed improved with subsidized childcare, financing schemes, support to women entrepreneurs, more focus on unequal wages, diversity targets in many companies. But the full economic equality and empowerment of women in the UNECE region is still far away, and the economic crisis has halted, or in some cases even reversed, progress. If you take from 2004 to 2012, only 6 out of the 56 member states in the ECE region has narrowed the gap between women and men's participation in the workforce by more than 5 percentage points. And out of these six, in four of the six countries, the gap narrowed, not because women's situation improved, but because men's situation got worse. Inequalities persist, sometimes at drastic levels. Throughout our region, women are still doing caregiving and homework, have less job security, are paid less than men for the same work, get fewer benefits, less fulfilling careers, and in the end, less economic independence. A woman in the EU will, on average, get a 40% lower pension when she retires than the average man. That's a huge difference. And young women's unemployment in southern European countries has gone up to over 50%. It's not good enough. And remember, if we did better, the entire economy would benefit. Women's representation in policy making and decision making has improved. Now, when I was a minister in Denmark, the country was ruled by Her Majesty the Queen. The Prime Minister was a woman. Number two in the government was a woman. Number three in the government was a woman. And sometimes we men felt slightly marginalized. But luckily, this trend is seen in many countries. The average ratio of women in parliaments of our region rose from less than 1 out of 5 to now 1 out of 4 during the past 10 years. It's better, but it is, of course, not good enough. And in some countries, it is only 1 out of 10. Many more women now act as managers in private companies and in public organizations, but less than 1 out of 10 CEOs are women, and very few women are on corporate boards. And when it comes to government bodies, we don't even know because of lack of data. So more needs to be done here, and more can be done, as some countries have proved already. Even more serious it is when we tomorrow turn our attention to one of the worst abuses of human rights in our society, violence against women. It's now widely condemned by law, awareness, attention has grown, but the economic crisis has also reduced funding to some services like abuse hotlines and shelters for the victims. Too many victims of violence do not seek help. They are ashamed to seek help or justice. In many communities, it is still a hidden problem that people do not talk about. But the problem is huge. Again, in the EU, estimates that 1 out of 3 women undergoes physical violence in their lifetime. And this shocking number may even be higher. And the background document for tomorrow's panel, prepared by UNICEF, details the staggering extent of the problem: honor killings, trafficking, stalking, sexual harassment, physical abuse, and rape. It is definitely not acceptable. Governments, police, courts, civil society, companies, communities, citizens, all of us must do more to protect women from violence. We must act with urgency. This is closely linked to the issue of governance and gender justice. Again, countries have improved their legislation, strengthened women's rights, but women are not always able to access the benefits of the new laws or to fight for their rights. And this is especially true for certain groups of women and girls: migrants, those with disabilities, rural women, minority women, refugees, victims of armed conflict or natural disasters. Improved access to justice must reach out to all, and here again we need active involvement and active community involvement. This was a brief introduction to our thematic discussions during the next 2 days. And apart from our formal meeting, there will be several side events. All touch on very important topics: women in armed conflict, women with disabilities, and trafficking. I encourage you to attend as many of those side events as you can. Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ECE is strongly engaged and committed to promote gender equality and empowerment of women in the region, both in our own work and in working together with our member states and partners. We will help our member states to collect and use sex disaggregated data in their policy practices and focus on the economic aspects of gender, including women's entrepreneurship. We will do our best. I'm sure all of you will do your best. So let's work together to boost the Beijing agenda, and let's work together to shape the new sustainable development goals and agenda so that every girl and every woman can live in safety and with dignity. Thank you for your attention.